Hello students, in the present lecture we will see the contribution of Marco Polo, Columbus and Vasco da Gama in the development of geographical thought as well as in the search of new lands, what and in what way they have contributed. Friends, before learning the contribution of these great explorers, first of all we will see the background of the impact of explorations and discoveries. Man throughout the history has always been a wanderer, searcher and explorer. In 330 BC, the Greeks sailed around Britain into the North Sea. Alexander the Great also made important explorations through Persia to India. In the 1st and 2nd century BC, the Romans, to expand their empire, reached up to River Nile. Norsemen discovered Iceland in 867, and then he also discovered 982. So these are the great examples of explorations done by then explorers and brave traders and searchers. At the same time, Arabs were also traveled through Indian Ocean to India, Malaysia, Indonesia and China. Ibn Battuta visited almost every Muslim country in almost 30 years at that time. In addition to that, Buddhist missionaries also always traveled to India and China. The art of navigation was improved by using magnetic compass. German cartographer Martin Waldseemüller produced the map of the world in which both North and South America clearly shone. There were new developments in cartography. Mercator invented new projection in 1569. Therefore, the first globe of the world was made and new accurate maps of the countries and world were made, which greatly helped in the discoveries of new unknown lands. Friends, Christopher Columbus from Italy, Vasco da Gama from Portugal, Marco Polo from Italy and Captain James Cook from Britain, through their adventurous voyages made great contribution in the discovery of new lands. The great age of discovery thus brought about many changes in the world outline and revived the concepts about the shape and size of the earth and about the dimensions of the countries and continents. Now we will see the work of some important explorers. In the beginning, we'll see the contribution given by Marco Polo. The period of Marco Polo was between 1254 to 1324. Marco Polo was a Venetian merchant, explorer and writer who traveled through Asia along the Silk Road between 1271 and 1295. His travels are recorded in the book The Travels of Marco Polo. This book describes the then culture of Eastern world. It also described the culture of China, Persia, India and Japan. Marco Polo's family had trade with the Middle East for a long time. His father Niccolo and Uncle Maffeo had been to China at the time of Kublai Khan. In 1260, Marco Polo participated in his first expedition with his father. From Venice, they went to Constantinople, that is Istanbul, in Turkey. From there, they sailed across the Black Sea to Crimea. From there, they traveled to River Volga by land. Then they entered in the kingdom of Kublai Khan, which was the Mongol Empire. And then they traveled to Bukhara and ended their journey in 1265. They established good relationships with Emperor Kublai Khan and returned to Europe. In 1271, Marco Polo traveled to Palestine, and from then they went to Acre, which is in Turkey. From Acre, they proceeded to Ayas, which is also in Turkey. They passed through Erzurum, which is placed in eastern Turkey, and Tabriz, which is in north Iran. From there, they traveled to eastern Iran through desert. Then they entered in Afghanistan. After that, they also visited many places in China, and finally they reached to Mongol Empire to visit Kublai Khan again. For next 15-16 years, they lived in the Mongol Empire. In next few years, Marco Polo visited to Champa, which is in Vietnam, and also many Malaysian islands. Through the Pacific Ocean, Marco Polo traveled to Nicobar Islands. Then they visited Sri Lanka. Then through the Arabian Sea, he traveled towards the Persian Gulf of Hormuz. Further, he traveled to Europe and visited to Tabriz, and then they finally reached to Venice in 1295. Marco Polo wrote a famous book entitled Book of Various Enterprises. His book Il Milione, that is The Million, which is known in English as Travels of Marco Polo, is considered a classic book of geography. So in this way, through the visits and expedition in different parts of the world, Marco Polo gave his contribution in the search of new lands and to find out new routes towards different parts of the world. After that, we'll see the work of Christopher Columbus. Christopher Columbus was the Italian explorer and very famous as the discoverer of an America. He, along with his brother, lived in Lisbon. He developed his knowledge of navigation and map making in Lisbon. He also participated in voyages of Iceland in 1477, Madeira in 1478, and west coast of Africa in 1483. The study of navigational theory gradually strengthened in Columbus that the earth was spherical and he thought that one can reach to Eastern Asia by sailing towards the west. However, he estimated the size of the earth as a whole. He considered the size of the earth small as a whole. In 1492, he got money and other support from the King of Spain for his expedition. Then he started his first journey with the ships Santa Maria and other two small ships towards the Japan. In his first voyage, Columbus discovered some islands near western coast of America. He named these islands as West Indies. Then he reached to home in 1493. On September 1493, Columbus started his second voyage with 17 ships and about 1500 men. He landed to Dominica and discovered the islands of Mari Galante, Guadeloupe, Montserrat, Antigua, Santa Cruz, Puerto Rico, and Virgin Islands. He founded new settlements on the coast of Ecuador at Isabela, which became the first European town of the New World. Then he sailed to Cuba, which he thought as an Asiatic mainland. In March 1496, he returned to home, that is in Spain. After 2 years, Columbus again started his third voyage with 6 ships. On this voyage, he discovered Trinidad and the mouth of River Orinoco. He gave it the name Dragon's Mouth. Then he also visited Haiti in this voyage. Columbus sailed on his fourth and last voyage on May 1502. This voyage was carried out to find a westward passage to Asia. In this expedition, he discovered Honduras and attempted to establish a colony at Belen. But due to protest of natives, he has to abandon the project and he returned to Jamaica. Then he reached Spain in 1504. Now, we will see the work of Vasco da Gama. The period of Vasco da Gama was between 1460 to 1524. Vasco da Gama was a great explorer from Portugal. Christopher Columbus discovered the New World, but he was failed to search westward route to Asia. At the same period, the King of Portugal chose Vasco da Gama to discover the sea route to India by east. Vasco da Gama was a member of Portuguese army. He was expert navigator and courageous explorer. Under the command of Vasco da Gama, a group of 4 ships sailed for India in 1497. He travelled towards south along the western coast of Atlantic Ocean. After 96 days and travelling almost 4,500 miles, they reached at St. Helena Island. Then they proceeded towards the southern end of the Africa continent. Fighting with bad weather, they reached finally to the Cape of Good Hope. From there, they sailed to the north of the Zambezi River and they stayed there for a month. At this place, for the first time in the history, the disease of scurvy broke out. The hands and feet of the crew swelled. Their gums grew over their teeth so that they could not eat. Still, in these worst situations, they sailed towards north along the western coast of Arabian Sea towards Mozambique. At Mozambique, they found ships of Arab traders. With the help of Arabs, they finally reached to Mombasa and visited the King Melindi. From Mombasa, they sailed to the east across the Arabian Sea and finally reached to the west coast of India at Calicut. Vasco da Gama met the king of Calicut on 28 May 1498. He established the commercial relationships with the king and left India taking variety of spices along with him. Vasco da Gama received extraordinary honor and warmth in Portugal. He also carried out his second voyage to India from 1502 to 1503. He was appointed as Viceroy of Portuguese Asia in 1524, but very soon in December 1524, he died at Cochin in India. So friends, this was the contribution given by some great explorers and discoverer in the search of new land.